Welcome back. It's round four, and I'm playing for the 4-0 record with Modern Elves. I'm on the play with just about the best draw possible, so I'd say things are going according to plan so far. Let's hope for the sake of the video that this last opponent is playing Eldrazi and that he or she has better draws than my last opponent did. But no, seems... I guess it could still be Eldrazi, but it looks more like Scapeshift or Through the Breach or something. Alright. Turn 2 Archdruid is more or less the best thing you can... Or not the best thing you can be doing. There are certain nut draws involving Heritage Druid where you can be even more explosive, but turn 1 Mana Guy, turn 2 Elvish Archdruid is certainly a nice, solid default start that I'm quite pleased with. So being on the play with this kind of draw, if I find something, if I find a Zuri, or maybe another Lord off of my next two draw steps and the Elvish Visionary, then I have a good chance of just being able to goldfish on turn 4 before my opponent can scapeshift. Naturally, I don't have much defense against a board sweeper, so if my opponent has Fire Spout or Anger of the Gods or whatever it might be, then I'm probably dead, but that's fine. That's kind of what you sign up for when you play Elves. So let's think about how to sequence my cards here. Looks like I should probably just play Dwynan's Elite and Llanowar Elves and then tap the Archdruid for 5 mana. That way I can play whatever I draw into with the Visionary. And think this is going to put enough creatures in play that... Let's see, so... This is going to be 9, 13 damage on the board, so not lethal unless I draw either another creature off the Visionary or an Archdruid or a Zuri for my next draw step, but pretty good chance of just goldfishing for turn 4 on the play with this draw. My opponent, I don't think my opponent can scapeshift for 7 mana next turn. Yeah, only going to have 5, so won't have enough mana to go Rampant Growth, scapeshift. So it's really just a board sweeper that I have to be worried about here. But there's no point playing around it, because if my opponent has a board sweeper, then I'm going to start trying to rebuild, and I'm probably just dead to scapeshift anyway. So by far my greatest chance of winning is just playing out my guys and crossing my fingers that there's no Anger of the Gods in my opponent's hand. Wow. Well, that's sweet. If this was a Llanowar Elf and I had a green mana open for regeneration, then that might change the equation here. I think as it stands, so the options are, I could leave a Zuri in my hand, and that will make my opponent miscount combat damage and maybe think that he or she has an extra turn more than they do. However, the downside of that is if my opponent has exactly one spot removal spell and kills the Archdruid, then I cannot win the game next turn. So I think I'm going to stick with the original plan, which was to be as aggressive as possible, play out everything, and I'm just going to attack for 2 and hope that I can untap with these creatures next turn. Playing Elves is not for the faint of heart. You get in a lot of spots like this where it's just like, okay, I definitely win if my opponent does not have Anger of the Gods, and I definitely lose if my opponent does. And you just gotta sort of sit there and hope. Well, not yet. Pyroclasm? That is not going to cut it, my friend. You can kill Azuri, but I think I still have 15 on the board, right? No, I have 13 on the board. Yeah, 13 damage on the board. So I'm. If I don't draw another lord, then I'm dead to land scapeshift. I have 20 life, so my opponent is going to need an eighth land in play in order to win the game. See what we can do. Well, I guess I just attack with everything and then play that. Maybe at this point I don't play the Dwinen's Elite because if my opponent sweeps the board, then maybe I can start to mount a defense. What if my opponent doesn't have a land and has to scape shift? And just lightning bolt a bunch of things. Seems like I should probably just play it, I guess. Eh. The odds of scape shift and no land drop and just scape shift to wipe my board. Yeah, I'll just not play it. Pretty unlikely to matter either way. Dead to Scapeshift. I might not be dead to Primeval Titan, though. I guess maybe I should have played it because sometimes these decks have Through the Breach Emrakul. But my opponent will still need something else, even with a with an Emrakul attack. I also probably should have counted what would happen if my opponent had Primeval Titan and just started Valakutting some of my creatures to death. Maybe it was a big mistake to not play it, but it looks like I'm just going to be dead to Escape Shift anyway. Man, what a close game. I maybe could have won if I didn't play the Azuri and my opponent chose not to kill the Archdruid with the Sakura Tribe Elder. But I'm not really, I don't know why my opponent wouldn't just kill the Archdruid right away. Or if I had not played the Azuri and then I had drawn Nykthos or something. I don't know. Oh well, close game. I'm going to bring in all my defense against the red board sweepers. And I think those are the only cards I'm going to bring in. Spellskite can be okay against Lightning Bolt, but I don't think I want it in my deck. And then pretty much just trimming here and there. Want to keep my deck fast, but I want to have a bit of resilience against sweepers and a little bit of staying power if my opponent just, survives the first rush. think this is an unfavorable matchup for Elves. The problem is that you can just lose in a straight-up race, just goldfish against goldfish, but also they can set you back or completely destroy you with a board sweeper. So it's almost like there are two ways that the Scapeshift deck can win and only one way that the Elf deck can win. But, I mean, it's certainly not hopeless. Like, Elves is fast and explosive, and I have a few ways to beat a board sweeper. So if I just have a good draw with a one well-placed defensive spell, then I can win. All right, I like this hand. I would trade the Lead the Stampede for an Archdruid if I could, but basically I have mana, I have a business spell, and I have the anti-sweeper card. So can't ask for more than this. So this turn, the move is probably Llanowar Elf, Forge Tender. I would say that Anger of the Gods is much more likely than Pyroclasm, but I think my draw lends itself to being able to play around Pyroclasm, and there's just no reason to risk complete and utter decimation by not playing the Forge Tender this turn. Plus, I can still get all of my mana to play this turn. It's like debatable whether I prefer to get the Llanowar Elves or the Dwinen's Elite into play anyway. So, I like this for sure. Opponent's playing a little slowly, maybe multi-queuing. Sorry for the pace of the video. Let's talk about this sweet sideboard card that I brought in for this matchup, Pay No Heed. This card has a number of applications. I mentioned it against Kozilek's Return. It's also very good against Infect, because you can fog a creature even through the Hexproof, the Shroud effect of Vines of the Vastwood. But for this matchup, it's especially great because I can have it to counter a board sweeper, counter a Pyroclasm or an Anger of the Gods, or it can prevent all the damage that a Valakut would deal in a turn. So, for example, if my opponent scapeshifts with only 7 lands in play, I can just go Pay No Heed to the Valakut, your whole scapeshift is countered. Now, it doesn't work if my opponent has, like, say 9 lands in play and is dealing way, way overkill damage. But, the ability to counter a sweeper and once in a while blow out the opponent's combo if the game plays out a certain way, I think it's a pretty sweet card. And there it is. So I can either attack. I don't need to hold this mana up yet. So I guess the first thing I should do is probably cast Lead the Stampede. pretty good haul. Now I'll play the Dwendin's Elite. And I'll attack for one. So I think the way my opponent can win this game is by getting to 8 lands quickly and casting Scapeshift. Board Sweeper's not going to do it since I have the Forge Tender and the Pay No Heed for backup. And if my opponent has to Scapeshift with only 7 lands, Pay No Heed can win me the game. So I think my course of action is if I can play Azuri and hold up white mana this turn, then it's going to put my opponent in a pretty tough position because I'm threatening lethal next turn. So sure, why don't I go Temple Garden untapped. I'm going to try to sequence this in a weird way so that my opponent doesn't know so that it's not as obvious that I'm leaving up a white mana. What exactly do I want to get into play this turn? Azuri and Dwinen's Elite or Azuri and Llanowar Elves? I guess I want to get Azuri and Dwinen's Elite into play, so yeah, this was a bad play for this reason. I should have attacked first. Like I said, I'm kind of purposely sequencing things incorrectly this turn because I don't want it to be super obvious that I'm leaving up a white mana. But my opponent might just think that I'm leaving up regeneration with Azuri. Summoner's Pact. Okay. I think Pay No Heed might come in handy here. My opponent pacted for a Sakura Tribe Elder, indicating that he's going to go for a Scapeshift with 7 lands? Or what's going on here? Why would you pact for a Tribe Elder and then cast a Titan? Well, Pay No Heed is going to work out here anyway. Choose a source. A source is a permanent spell or effect in the effects area. Alright, so Valakut's not dealing any damage this turn. I wonder if this is the first time my opponent has had Pay No Heed cast against him. The first time I've cast it on a Valakut, it's pretty sweet. Listen, buddy, I'm paying no heed to your Valakut. What's so confusing about that? So, my opponent doesn't have any free spells here, then I'm going to untap and overrun and bring it to game three. But then I'll have to win a sideboarded game against Scapeshift on the draw, which is pretty tough if my opponent has a good hand. I haven't seen any board sweepers yet, although it's pretty hard to imagine that a red-green ramp deck would have zero board sweepers in its 75. I mean, maybe this guy has just decided that Lightning Bolt is better, but I'm going to expect to play against both. This guy is either in disbelief or has to ask a rules question, or I don't know, telling a bad beat story to his friend on Instant Messenger. I don't know. All right, so let's swing with these guys and overrun. Cool. On to game three. And I don't think I have any reason to adjust my sideboarding after that game. I still like having three Azuris. Maybe I prefer a Visionary over a Lead the Stampede. Here we go. Elves is really fun. I enjoy playing Elves in just about every format that is legal. Which I guess is only Modern and Legacy right now. Although I loved playing like the old underpowered Elf combo decks in Standard. Like my favorite one I had, it was just like you didn't have Glimpse of Nature or really anything good like that, but you had Green Sun Zenith and Primal Command, so deck would be like, okay, Nettle Sentinel, Heritage Druid, make some mana, Primal Command your land, go. Or you'd be like, yeah, Primal Command, put your land on top of your library, search for Regal Force, hope that you don't have anything, and then I can cast Regal Force next turn and keep playing some guys. And I had some good results with those old kind of homebrew elf combo decks in old Standard. I like them a lot. This one feels certainly in the middle. Like it's a lot more clean and direct, like your game plan. Everything's kind of low to the ground. You've collected company. So you're really just trying to flood the board as fast as possible. You don't have to get too techie with like Ranger of Eos or Regal Force or anything like that. But this still has some of those aspects where you're not actually comboing off and winning all in one turn. It's more like you gotta piecemeal things together. So it's a little bit in between. It is really fun though. I recommend you give it a try if you're looking for a new non-Eldrazi modern deck to take for a spin. So I'm probably going to need my opponent to not have a perfect draw here. Like a mulligan, or a missed land drop, or something like that will be enough. That's all I need, is a tiny bit of breathing room. But if my opponent has a great draw with like a board, turn three board sweeper, turn four titan, or something like that, that's going to be pretty tough. This is torturous, just waiting here. Of course it'll work out that my opponent scapeshifts and kills me with like 20 seconds left on his or her clock, just for maximum punishment. But, you know, another minute or two, my opponent's got to start worrying about timing out, even though Modern is a really fast format. So of the decks that are popular in Modern right now, mentioned that I think Elves is a modest favorite over Eldrazi. Eldrazi is just so good that you can never really count yourself, you know, too heavy a favorite. But I do think Elves is a little bit ahead there, just based on its explosiveness. Affinity, you're probably an underdog in game, or you're certainly an underdog in game one. If you sideboard like four or five cards, the matchup can be good, I'd say. Infect is definitely really tough. You also have to sideboard four or five cards to beat Infect. The problem there is that the cards are a lot more narrow. Like, for example, if you're putting Malira on your sideboard, that's not coming in any other matchup besides Infect. So that's one where it takes a lot of work to make the matchup good, and it's not necessarily in your best interest to try to make Infect a good matchup. But I got a couple Path to Exiles in my sideboard, so a fast clock and a well-placed path. Sometimes you can steal a game. My opponent has Mulligan down to five cards here. Scry to the top, so the game's not over. But that is a now I feel like a jerk, and I'm like, oh, that's what I was asking for, is my opponent to Mulligan. I was just asking for my opponent to not have the perfect draw. A functional draw is fine. Let's have a good game here, but I can't beat a perfect draw. I can beat a mulligan to five, I think. So, Search for Tomorrow coming off suspend next turn. I don't really have a draw where I can play around a board sweeper, so let's just put this Archdruid into play, see what my opponent has for me next turn. Thing about this Scapeshift deck is it needs all its resources to operate. So it's like, say my opponent mulligans to five, draws one lightning bolt, suddenly there's just not enough cards left to have seven lands and a Scapeshift, you know? So three cards in hand right now. Suppose they could be land, ramp, spell, Scapeshift. Okay, so we got a game. My draw has not panned out. I've just drawn three lands, I believe, and lost my Archdruid to the anger. So if my opponent has a Titan or something, I'm gonna lose. Okay, that's decent. Not going to save me from a Titan or a Scapeshift, but Certainly better than nothing. Let's start by cracking the canopy, try to get some business. Azuri. I like it. What to cast first? So if I play Forest Azuri, then I can attack for 1, and next turn I can overrun, hit for 13. Or I can play Forge Tender, attack for 2. So basically, I'm going to win in 2 turns with either way. So that therefore, I might as well take the slower, safer route of playing the Forge Tender before I play the Azuri. Because if I play the Azuri and I get Anger of the Gods again, or if I get even just the Azuri gets bolted, I'm going to lose. I think I cannot beat a Titan, though I can maybe beat a Scapeshift now. Wonder what my opponent could have that he or she would be thinking about here. Could have Landscape Shift and be thinking about what to do. No Titan, no Titan, no Titan, no Titan. Okay. So I guess can either deal me 18 and I'll be dead to a land, or he can kill some of my creatures. So ironically, if my opponent does 18 to me, now I'm in a position where I'm crossing my fingers that my opponent draws Anger of the Gods, because it's one of the only cards that doesn't kill me. I could draw Pay No Heed. That's it, though. That's the only thing I can draw that can protect me. I can't kill my opponent from this position, I don't think. So I have to either draw Pay No Heed, or I have to cross my fingers and hope that my opponent bricks. All right, Visionary. All right, you're clocked for next turn. Please don't draw a land or a ramp spell. Please just draw a Lightning Bolt or an Anger of the Gods or a Prismatic Omen. Huh? I'm not dead yet. What is it? Oh, it's another Valakut. Oh my goodness. What a finish. Wow. I can't believe I survived that turn. What a match. So I attack with all my creatures, I use the Nykthos, and I overrun. And that's it. By the skin of my teeth, I make it to 4-0 with Elves. Wow. Well, that was a blast. I had a great time. As I record this, I'm 2 days before the Modern Grand Prix in Detroit, and Elves is the deck that I would like to play. Not sure if it's going to be wind up being good enough to choose over Eldrazi, but I love this deck. I had a great time recording this video. I hope you'll give Elves a try. Be part of the solution. Try to beat the Eldrazi deck instead of just caving in and playing it yourself. Yeah, thanks for watching.